So students, in this video I am going to explain you the practical of chromatography. Chromatography, it's a special type of paper which you can see. It's a big sheet and we cut it into small pieces to facilitate this chromatography experiment. Okay. The chromatography, the word chroma, it means color, and graphy means reading. Earlier it was used to separate colored substances. Okay. Like in today's experiment, I have taken mixture of blue ink and red ink. Okay, it's a mixture of blue ink and red ink. And when we will put it in a suitable solvent. Right now I have taken water. It can be alcohol also and even solvent also as per the requirement. So then we have to put a dot on this, put a drop of ink on this baseline. Okay, this is a line, horizontal line which I have drawn over here. About 2.5 centimeter above this paper. Okay, this line is called baseline, and in the middle you put one dot with the help of pencil. Okay, so that is the point where you have to put the mixture of red and blue ink. Okay, and before I start the practical, let me tell you what is the principle of chromatography. The chromatography is based on the principle of adsorption. Okay, adsorption. Okay, so there are two phases. One is fixed phase. This is the fixed phase. Okay, this is the adsorbent. Fixed phase is the adsorbent. Adsorbent means the surface area on which adsorption process takes place. And next is the mobile phase. Now this is your mobile phase. This solvent is the mobile phase. And when this mixture solution is put, that also moves along with the solvent. As the solvent rises, right now you will see. As the solvent rises, along with that, this dot of blue and red ink also rises. And red and blue ink have different rate of adsorption, so it achieves different heights. Are you getting it? These red and blue inks achieve different heights. So then we find the RF value. Okay, RF value for the red ink and RF value for the blue ink. For that, I'll give you the formula. Okay. So first of all, this, and you have to be very very precautious while you add a drop of ink on this. Okay, you have to touch it. The drop should not spread. It should not be too large. Okay, you can change your position here. Come here, this side. Okay, to touch it like this, take it back. Okay, now allow it to dry. Sometimes you can further concentrate it. Okay, but I think one drop is enough. Now you have to write your roll number and like that, okay, so that you can identify your paper. Now you have to put it in the solvent chamber, and you should always take care that the solvent should not touch the baseline. Solvent should lie below the line drawn by the pencil. Getting it? Uske niche hona chahiye. Otherwise, your ink drop will spread out. Now you see the solvent is rising slowly. It takes about 1 hour. Okay. Now you have to distinguish. Right now I am doing it to separate the red and blue ink. Like the liquids which have like fixed melting point, you have fixed boiling point. On the basis of melting and boiling point, you can distinguish the compound. Suppose liquid is boiling at 100 degrees Celsius, it means it is water. If liquid is boiling at 77 degrees Celsius, it means it is alcohol. In the same way, different compounds have different RF values. Getting it? So on the basis of RF value, you can detect. You will calculate the RF value, then you will compare it with the literature. Achha, ye RF value kis compound ki hoti hai. On the basis of it, you can distinguish the compound also. Getting it? And this is the paper chromatography. Similarly, there is gas chromatography is also there. Okay. Then thin line chromatography is also there. There are different types of chromatography. So in this, you have to calculate the RF value. So RF is the distance traveled by RF from the red ink. On the distance covered by red ink from the baseline, divided by distance covered by solvent from baseline. Similarly, you can find the RF value of the blue ink. So blue ink, it will be distance covered by
blue ink.
From baseline and distance. solvent from the basement. So like that you can calculate. Okay. But its actual application is used to, you know, distinguish the compounds. Okay. Here we have simply taken the